For more on tonight's marquee matchups, we welcome in CBS NBA insider Bill Reiter. Bill, at the start of the season, everyone really had the Lakers and the Bucks circled, but at certain points this month, they had us both asking the same question. What's wrong with them right now? Perhaps as the calendar turns, so too will the tide. Let's start with the Lakers. They break the losing streak against Portland, then tag the Warriors Sunday night. What impressed you most about the way LA showed up in this spot?
Yeah, important win. I think important reminder for whoever was out there that makes the mistake we've made over the years. That's doubting LeBron James team when they struggle. This Lakers team got to it the way they need to if they want to make, and I think we all believe they can, a championship run. And that's with really impressive defense. Joe, you hit on it. They absolutely flabbergasted Seth Curry and the rest of that Warriors team. LeBron James in that first half didn't play a lot of minutes after the domination of the rest of that team. Incredible defense, best defensive rating in the NBA. And when they can assert their will defensively the way they did in this game, you know they're going to do it offensively, and good things tend to happen.
Just a couple of nights ago, we sat in these very chairs trying to brainstorm how LeBron's going to find some rest in this most recent marathon of his career. Sunday, King James limited to a season-low 24 minutes thanks to the blowout. How important are nights like this and getting more of them in the grand scheme of things for LBJ?
I think it's huge. I know LeBron James doesn't want to hear it. I know he calls himself a warrior and he expects to play lots and lots of minutes, but I think you're absolutely right. You have to find ways to rest LeBron. There's two ways to do that. One are nights like tonight where you just dominate a team like the Warriors and you don't have to play late in the game. And the other is you win so many basketball games, you're on such a roll, LeBron James can just take a night off here or there against weak opponents. But obviously, Joe, that hasn't been possible. The Lakers have been losing games before this Warriors contest, not winning them. So this is not just a much-needed win. This is a much-needed rest for their most important player.
I'm hoping he can pass the baton off to AD again at some point, take a night or two off here and there as they get set for yet another deep playoff push. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We got to talk about another big one, the Bucks outlasting LA's second son on Sunday as well. Thanks in part to a monster fourth quarter out of Giannis. Bill, the man seemingly has the ability to take over a game at will. He's averaging 35.5 points over this recent five-game heater. Do you expect to see more of this Giannis on the other side of the All-Star break? Because, to be fair, he's been hit or miss before this recent stretch. Kind of goes missing from time to time, and he's really turned it on over the last week plus.
It's interesting. For whatever reason, the Bucks have been as impacted as any team, maybe this side of the Lakers, by the shortened offseason. Maybe there's something tied up in the fact that Giannis got this massive contract, and sometimes guys respond differently the first few months when they lock in that kind of a deal. But it's easy to forget a couple facts, and we saw it tonight, especially with that thunderous dunk. One, Giannis is a back-to-back MVP. That has not happened many times in the history of the NBA, and obviously he's a young guy in the prime of his skills. And two, this is still a really good Bucks team. There's only three teams in the NBA that have both a top offense and a top defense. One of those teams, interestingly, is the Phoenix Suns. The other is the Utah Jazz. I think we'd agree they're the best team or one of the two best teams in the NBA. Their other is the Milwaukee Bucks. So they've got a team that can play defense and offense. They're obviously missing some key players. They'll be coming back. And Giannis, we know, we saw tonight, is capable of being absolutely dominant. He might be the best player on earth. He's certainly a top three player. So I do think post All-Star game and when we get to the playoffs, what you saw from Giannis in this game, what you saw from the Bucks in this game, is going to be much closer to what they actually are than some of the weird play we've seen throughout the course of this regular season.
Bill Reiter, always dominant as well. Thank you, my friend.
Want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.